is Marianne. She's a student at Belvedere. It is 6:30 a.m. in the morning, and she just woke up on a normal school day. Marianne just went to breakfast. Meanwhile, we're gonna do a little room tour. This room looks like every other in the boarding house. It is built in a simple and functional style. There's a bathroom, a closet, a desk, and a bed. Normally, Marianne shares this room with another classmate, but due to the pandemic, this is not possible. At the moment, every student has his or her own room. Oh look, Marianne is back. She just grabbed her stuff for school and is on her way. Let's follow her. While Marianne is in school, let's take a look at the building from the outside. This building was built in the 1990s in the Bauhaus style and even won an architecture prize. Now we're going to take a walk around. From the outside, we can already look inside our concert hall because it has a very big glass window. But now let's look at it from the inside. Normally, this hall is only used for orchestra rehearsals and the school's concerts. But at the moment, we are in need of bigger rooms to keep the distance between the students. So we use this hall for lessons too. This is the ground floor of our school building. There is a chemistry, a physics, and an art room. Here on the left, we have a chamber music room. Upstairs, there are 8 different classrooms that all look the same. But in which did Marianne go? Let's go upstairs and have a look. Marianne currently has English lessons.
So in the last lesson, we tried to compare a film scene with a book scene. And I want you to tell me something about these characters in the book and compare them with the film characters. What is different? First of all, I want you to tell me something about the picture. What have you learned about the picture in the novel, Marianne?
The picture of Dorian changes, but in reality, he doesn't change.
Okay, and can anyone add anything? So what really changes, Eike?
Well, in reality, he stays the same age as in the picture.
Now the lesson is over. It's time for lunch. This is the cafeteria, the place where our students eat their meals. As you can see, the tables are separated at the moment, so our students can keep the distance. In the summer, we can eat outside and enjoy the sun. Let's meet Frau Brochner. She manages all our keys.
Hello.
Frau Brochner is wonderful. We like her a lot. But where did Marianne go? Let's have a look. This is the Mozarthaus, the place where all our practice rooms are. Downstairs, there's a sports hall where we have PE and rooms where we have music theory. But mainly, all these rooms are for practicing. Let's take a look at what Marianne is doing. Every practice room has a table with a chair, a piano, a mirror, and a music stand. As we all know, it is very important to take breaks during practicing, and I think Marianne is about to take a break. Thank you. me tell you about the history of this garden. Around 1800, the Duchess Maria Pavlovna married Karl Friedrich and had to move here from St. Petersburg to Weimar. Over the summer, she stayed at this residence with her husband. Maria Pavlovna was very homesick, and in order to feel a bit of comfort, this garden was made. It is a garden that resembles the one in St. Petersburg, her home. It has a symmetrical style and is a miniature form of this garden. There is a garden theater and a maze. This is the main building of Belvedere. Karl August ordered it to be built around 1750. It is built in a Rococo style. In the main building there's a museum. This is the Mozart House. It's the place where our practice rooms are. And the other three buildings belong to the Music University. This place is called the Orangerie. There is a very big greenhouse, as you can see, where the plants are kept during winter. At the moment, there are very few plants outside, but you can see some exotic plants over there. Thank you.